Welcome to our another video program. In the last video, we discussed about correlation and regression analysis in R program. In this video, we will discuss about LSD statistics. LSD, least significant difference, is one of the important statistical tool for applied and basic science. More importantly, in many agricultural resources, we use LSD. Let's start with importation of the file. I will give name of the file. I will assign from where I am going to import. Read.table file.choose and header is equal to true and separator is equal tab delimited, and I will run this program and I will import data from txt file. Let's see what type of data we have. You can just type tomato here. You will see the data here. We have treatment, food treatment, and we have the replication. We have 5 replication, and we have the shoot length, root length, and shoot weight and root weight measurement. As in the previous video, the data can also be viewed as str tomato command. Can see we have 20 observation with 6 variables. Now let's check about the summary statistics of our data set. You can see the summary here: treatment, replication, shoot length, root length, and shoot weight and root weight. Is we already discussed, you can also check the summary of individual variable, like tomato of, you can say shoot length, then you will get a summary only shoot length here. Before proceeding, I would like to extract name of our variables. Names of tomato. I will run it and you will get here the names of variables. I would like to copy here, and as I already mentioned, in front of this command I will press hash, so it will identify it as a description, not command. Now, another important thing, if you are running this LSD program in your R for first time, you need to install different packages which you can find in the online. I will teach you, don't worry. You can type install.package, and you need package agricole, agricolae. Then if you give this command, you will get the access and you can download this package. But in my case, I have already installed this package, so I need not to relaunch this package again. So I just run a library of agricole. Now it is okay. Now I can access library from agricoli. It is very necessary for LSD analysis. Okay, let's start our analysis. Before starting analysis, you need to know about your data set. In our data set, we have treatment. There are four treatments, four different treatments, and each treatment has five replications. And we have measurement from suit length, root length, suit width, and root width. So you need to understand about data first. Now I will write model. I will give name its model, and we have to provide analysis of variance. And first we have to choose any variables which we want to analyze. Let's take suit length first, and we have to see the differences among the suit lengths due to treatment. That's why we will take here treatment, TRT, and we have to define our data source. Data coming from tomato, you can see here. Then you can run it. Okay, now model is okay. Next time, next step, you can have coefficient of variance of model. In this case, we have the same name model. Run it, you will get CV of the model. Similarly, you can also have mean of the model, mean of the suit length. We have to define path here. Suit is coming from tomato. You can have the suit length here. This is the mean of the suit length. And let's go a step forward. We need degree of freedom. For the degree of freedom, I will define degree of freedom is residual of the model. Degree of freedom, residual of the model. You will run it, then you will get degree of freedom. Again, if you want to know about the degree of freedom, you can just type degree of freedom. You will get number here. Now you need MS error. MS error is defined as deviance of model which is divided by degree of freedom. Then I will run it again. Now you have degree of freedom and mean sum of surface square also. So now the tron is of LSD. We need lsd.test, and we have to give name of the model, in our case model itself, and we have to provide the treatment name. If you have the different treatment name, just put here your treatment name, and console is equal to true. If you run this, you will get this distinction here. You can have the result LSD test, mean square error, and by treatment, mean an individual at 95% confidence interval. Here is the measurement of the suit with the standard deviation, and here is the differences. You can see here. Similarly, you can find alpha, you can find degree of error, you can find critical value of the t. Similarly, t strength value, alpha, and the value of the least significant difference, that is 0.7798041. Means with the same letter are not significantly different. It also describes what is the significantly difference. In our result, treatment 1, 2, and 3 have same value. It means these three treatments are significantly not different. But in case of V, it is significantly different. You can see here. In this way, you can find your LSD value. Similarly, you can also check ANOVA of the model. You can see here the ANOVA of the model with treatment and residual, which is highly significant. In this way, you can do your LSD. You can repeat everything here, what I mentioned, for your each variables. We just finished analysis of suit length here. We can also do the same procedure for another variables. Let's say root length. I will copy here for the easiness and just copy here root length. You can just paste here is root length. You can also paste here root length and just change the name of the model from model 1. Okay, now our name is model 1. You can also, you have to change there, you have to change name here, change name here, and you have to change name here and here. Now we can run these all things at one click. Let's see, run it, you will get result. In this case, if you see the LSD value, LSD grouping, in case of the root length, treatment 2 and 1 are not significantly different, and treatment 3 and 4 are not significantly different, but 2 and 3 are different. Similarly, 2 and 1, sorry, 1 and 3 are different. You can see the model here. In this way, you can do your research of research, and you can analyze your data for LSD. It is pretty simple, isn't it? Thank you very much for watching the video. Don't forget to press the like button and don't forget to subscribe us. In another video, we will come up with another statistical tool. Till now, bye bye and thank you.